All right, now let's see these components in action. There are basically three steps you need to follow in order to use a component. First, you need to create a component. Second, you need to register that component in a module. And third, you need to add an element in your HTML markup. Let me show you what I mean by this. So, back in our first Angular project, first of all, make sure to run ng-serve to serve this application. So now if you head over to localhost port 4200, this is what you see. Beautiful. Now back in VS Code, I'm going to create a new component. So let's open up the file panel. Here in the source folder, under app, here I'm going to add a new file. Now let's imagine I want to create a component to display the list of courses. So look how I named this file. Courses.component.ts. This is the convention that we use when building Angular applications. Now, if the name of the component has multiple words, we separate them using a hyphen. For example, if you're building a component called course form, you would call this course-form and then .component.ts, okay? So courses.component.ts. Now here we start by creating a plain TypeScript class. So class courses component. Once again, look at the naming convention. Here I'm using the Pascal naming convention. So the first letter of every word should be capital. And also by convention, we use the suffix component in the name of the class. So here's our class. In order for Angular to see this class, first we need to export it. Now so far we have only a plain TypeScript class. This is not a component. In order to convert this to a component, we need to add some metadata to it that Angular understands. We use a decorator to achieve this. In Angular, we have a decorator called component that we can attach to a class to make that class a component. So first we need to import this decorator on the top. So import curly braces component from now the name of the library. So at @angular/core. This is the core library of Angular that you're going to see a lot in this course. So here we import the component decorator, and then we need to apply it to this TypeScript class. Now look at the syntax. We use @ component, and then call this like a function. So this is what we call a decorator function. Now this function, as you see here, takes an argument. So here we pass an object. And in this object, we add one or more properties to tell Angular how this component works. For example, one property that we use quite often is selector. So selector. And we set this to a CSS selector. So in CSS, if I want to reference an element like this, I use a selector like this. If I want to reference an element like a div that has a class called courses, my selector would be .courses, right? And if I want to reference an element with the ID courses, this is my selector. Just basic CSS, okay? So here we want to reference an element called courses. Why? Because with components, we can extend HTML vocabulary. So we can define new elements like courses, and inside that we will have the list of courses. Or in the future, we can define a custom element, a custom HTML element called rating, and wherever we use that, Angular will render a rating component, okay? So let's delete this. My selector for this component is courses. Now the second property we add here is template. And that's the HTML markup we want to be rendered for this component. Now here I want to render something very simple. So let's just add an H2 element and call this courses. In a real world application, our templates can be several lines of code. In that case, we can put them in a separate file, and I'm going to show you how that works later in the course. So this is a basic component in Angular. That was the first step. The second step is to register this component in a module. Now, currently our application has only one module, which we call app module. Let me show you where that is. So back here in the app folder, look, we have app.module. Now, once again, here we have three import statements on the top, so nothing special here. On the bottom, we have a TypeScript class called app.module. And note that this class is decorated with another decorator function called ng.module. So with this, we convert a plain TypeScript class to a module from Angular's point of view. Now, don't worry about all these properties here, like declarations, import, providers, and bootstrap. You're going to learn about them later in the course. What I want you to focus on now is this property, declarations. And this is where we add all the components that are part of this module. So by default, when we generate an application, we have one component called app component, and you can see that component is part of this module. Now I'm going to add our new component here. So courses component. So whenever I type the name of a class here and press enter, it automatically imports it on top of my file. So import courses component from, and here's the name of our TypeScript module. So period slash, which refers to the current folder. And here's the name of the file, courses.component. Now note that here we don't have .ts. In fact, if you add that, TypeScript component doesn't like that. So the name of the module is just the name of the file without the extension. So if you want to add this plugin to your VS Code, simply go here. And in the extension search box, search for auto import. So currently I'm using auto import 1.2.2. Simply install it and then you'll have to restart VS Code. All right, so here's our second step. Now the third step. Back to our component. So this is the selector for this component, which means anywhere we have an element like courses, Angular is going to render the template for this component inside that element. But where are we going to add that element? Let me show you. So back here in the app folder, we have this app.component.html. This is the external template for our app component. Let's have a look. So all this markup you see here is for rendering the homepage. And this is what we get. Now I want to simplify this. I'm going to get rid of all this markup, add a simple h1, call this Angular. And below that, I'm going to add our custom element, courses. So when Angular sees this element, it's going to render the template of our courses component. All right, now back in the browser, this is our new homepage. So let's right-click this courses element and inspect this. So look what we have here. We have this h1, and below that we have our courses element. And inside this, you can see, we have the template for our courses component. So this is how Angular applications work. As another example, look at this app root element inside the body element. Where is this app root? Well, back in the source folder, look at index.html. So this is the basic template for our application, right? Now, inside the body element, we have an element called app-root. This is a custom element because we don't have an element in HTML called app-root. So from Angular's point of view, we should have a component with a selector for this element. And that's our app component. Let's have a look at that. So back in the app folder, let's look at app.component.ts. So here's our root component, our app component. Look at the selector, app-root. So whenever Angular sees an element like that, it's going to render the template for this component inside that element. In this case, our template is external. So we have template URL, and you can see the name of our template file, app.component.html. So that's why inside app-root, here we have the template for app component, which includes an h1 and the courses element.